John MacLennan here, and in this video, we're gonna dive into one of the most epic blues guitar recordings of all time. In this video, we're gonna take a look at Crossroads, as recorded by Cream with Eric Clapton on guitar. Now, this song is all based around a 12-bar blues chord progression in the key of A, and I'm gonna show you this classic riff and also some of the just iconic lead parts that Clapton plays note for note. And if you're interested in blues guitar playing, before we dive into it, I wanna hook you up with something right away. At the first link down below, I've got an exclusive blues training series, and these are some videos that are not on YouTube and some downloads that are tabs and PDFs that you can get that go along with the videos that are gonna help you build a really solid foundation for playing blues guitar. So check that out as my gift to you, and with that said, let's dive into this lesson. Let's break down how to play Crossroads as recorded by Cream with Eric Clapton live, and we're gonna start off with this main riff, and all of this is based around a 12-bar blues in the key of A. Here's our first riff. It's just a little one-bar figure, and I like to think of this as based around an A shape. A lot of people play it up here, but Clapton actually played it here in this open position. So we're gonna play the fifth string open, then we'll go to the second fret on the third string and play 2-0-2. That's 1 and 2, and then do a little hammer on there from the open third string to the second fret, then go back to open, then play the third fret on the fifth string, and just give a little pull, a little blues bend. So, 3E and a 4E and a 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Okay, and as I mentioned, that's based around an A chord. So he'll start off that way. And I'm doing all downs with my strum hand. Then you can bring in a little bit more of the A chord. If you thought about this note here, this is just the A note out of the A chord. So you can bring in the note on the second string, which is the note C sharp. It adds like a little harmony. Instead of going, now I've got two notes, the third and the second strings on the second fret. And I do the same riff, but just doubling it now on the second string. And that's like a double stop hammer on. Then open, then the little pull. So I like to go two times with just the first riff, then beef it up with that extra note like this. Then we go to a D7 chord. And Clapton does some arpeggio picking here. Now this part's a little tricky. If this is too hard, just play a D7 chord here. But what Clapton does is, so that's a D7 chord. You're gonna play the fourth string twice, then the second string twice. Then play the third string and the first string. Then finish with the second string, and then a little pull again on that third fret of the fifth string. And that's 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. Then again, do a slightly different pattern. That's 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. So there I'm playing the fourth string, then the first string, come back, second string, third string. Then jump back up to the first string, second string, then the bend. So that would go. So those two bars together go one E and a two E and a three E and a four and one E and a two E and a three E and a four and up to speed. Then go back to the riff with the double stops. Then we finish with. This is a standard Eric Clapton turnaround here. We go to an E chord. One and two. That's on an E chord, just sort of bass, bass, and then the rest of the chord. Then bass chord slide. So that's bass chord, and then I grab the third fret and slide up to seven. Then we go into this really classic pentatonic phrase. That's just A minor pentatonic right there, right? Oh, notice the blues pull. Little bend there. Then, that's a pull off from seven to five on the third string. Then seven on the fourth string. Then five, five, seven. And a lot of times Clapton would use his middle finger. So like, instead of your traditional like sort of pentatonic fingering, he would go for more of a three finger style pentatonic. But that enabled him to really easily play these kinds of phrases with the strongest fingers. Again, if you're having trouble, just click the link below where you can get the tab. But this walk up goes one and two and three and four and. Then here's that turnaround lick in the last two bars. So that's, to me, I'm thinking an A major triad there, hammering from five to six, then five, five, then pull off eight to five, seven, five, then again a hammer. I'm just sort of dancing around this A major triad. Then, that's seven, again, hammer five to six, and then the fifth fret on the second string. Then finish with an E. And altogether, the last four bars sound like this. Three and four and. So let's put the whole thing together. We're gonna play it one time through. We'll start on that first riff on the open A string. Get set. One, two, three. Congrats on making it through this classic Crossroads guitar part. Remember to take your time with this. I mean, this is really high-level guitar playing, and there's so many advanced techniques just all blending together to be able to play this the way that Eric Clapton does. We're just scratching the surface of this song, so let me know if you would like to see more lessons diving deeper into this. Just comment it down below. And before you go, don't forget to get my exclusive blues training at the first link down below. And with these videos, you're gonna get some downloads. You'll even get one of my books that I wrote about guitar soloing. It's just a book of over 100 licks and exercises that come with audio downloads and everything. It's all for free. Check it out as my gift to you at the first link down below. Thanks for your support here with the lessons, and we'll see you in another video real soon.